Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. I'm going to show you how to couch yarn down onto fabric using your Janome sewing machine. So what I have is the Janome Free Motion Couching Foot Set. Like most Janome attachments, it has a very long name, but really I would call it the couching foot for the Janome. So it is actually part number 202110006, and I'll put that in the description below, so you can check for it at your local Janome dealer. It says on it that it's actually for memory craft embroidery machines and high shank models. So it may fit more than just the 8900, as a matter of fact, I'm sure it does. So what exactly is in this little set? Lots of little plastic and metal things. Okay, so this is what the attachment looks like. So it comes with this attachment. It sort of looks like a hopping foot kind of thing, but it's got a little plastic part on here, and that's where the yarn is going to go into and be pulled down to be couched onto the fabric. Now there's two interchangeable little plastic kind of feet, I guess, if you want to call them that. So the difference in them, it's hard to tell when you look at them, but the difference is the size of the hole in the middle. So for example, this little one here, they have numbers on them too, I should tell you. This one here, and it's very hard to see them because they're acrylic, of course, but this is the number 1 foot here. And the one I have on the attachment right now is the number 2. So the numbers, if you can see them, are just here. It says 2 here. It's very small to see. But it came with the number 1 attached, but I had to switch it out to the number 2 because the number 1, the hole in it, was too big for the yarn I was using. And so what happens then is it doesn't actually catch the yarn as the stitch is going back and forth. So if you're having problems with it, with the stitch on your machine catching the yarn and couching it down, try to switch out the little plastic part and you may have better success. Now to switch out the plastic part, as you'll see, there's a little screw on the side. So you just need to loosen it, pull out the one plastic part, put the other one in. These are a little tough to pull out and to push in, just to let you know. So you might have to use a little bit of pressure on that, but you'll be able to do it, and then just tighten the screw back up and you'll be ready to try it again. Now, like all Janome attachments, this comes with cardboard in the back. And remember, you want to keep that because it tells you how to attach the attachment to the machine. It gives you instructions on how to use it and tips. So you want to make sure you read through this, and you also want to make sure that you keep it. So I tend to just put my attachments right back in the packaging and just keep them and put them in my drawer. If you don't have room for that, at least keep the cardboard part of it. So now I'm going to put the attachment on the machine, and then I'll talk about how to get the yarn into the attachment. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you something about the attachment that's easier to show you when the attachment's off than on the machine. When you pull the yarn in, you're going to be pulling it from the back of the machine in through this little groove here. So that's where your yarn is going to go, and then it's going to come down and be pulled in through the little hole in the bottom plastic part. So that little indent there is where the yarn is going to rest. Okay, let's put the attachment on the machine. So I put the attachment on the machine, but there's a few other things you have to do before we're ready to start couching. First off, let's talk about what I've got on the machine. I've got monofilament thread in the top. I've got regular 50 weight cotton in the bobbin. And so you're threading up your machine like you normally would. And then I've got some yarn. This is just regular acrylic yarn. This is inexpensive yarn, this is, just to show you. Let's talk about the stitch we're going to be using. So I have it on a zigzag stitch, number 9 on my machine. You want to make sure that the width is no wider than 1.5, and then you're going to drop your feed dogs. Okay, at which point in time the width disappears on your machine, but still it's going to go back and forth. Anything wider than 1.5 and you might hit the plastic part and break the foot, break your needle, mess up your machine. So you don't want to do that. So make sure you change that down to 1.5. I've also adjusted the tension on my machine at the top. It's set at 2. Okay, so now we're going to take some fabric, and by the way, I have stabilized my fabric. You might want to do that because you are putting some yarn on top and there's a lot of tension to hold that on there. It's not a bad idea to avoid some wrinkling and pulling up of the fabric just to have some stabilizer on the back. And then what I want to do is I want to feed the yarn in. Now you've got all this yarn here. What's going on with all this yarn? Well, I pulled off quite a bit because what's important in this technique is to make sure that you have your yarn, lots of slack yarn, on your fabric just off to the side, because this the stitches that we're doing here are not actually pulling the yarn in, they're tacking the yarn down. So if you get to a point where there's no slack in your yarn, you're gonna have a problem. It's not gonna be couching for you. So periodically you'll have to stop, pull a bunch more yarn off, and then you'll be good to go again. So how do I get the yarn in here? Well, what you do, remember we talked about that little groove in the attachment? You're gonna take your yarn, looks really awkward, but You're going to take your yarn and it's going to come in through that groove, which is really hard to see right now. But basically, you're coming in between the main part. Let me just show you. The main part of the attachment, the shaft of the attachment, the little groove is right there between it and your needle, basically. And it feeds in pretty easily. If you need to, you might want to take some long tweezers. Like I've got tweezers that might be helpful to pull that yarn in if you're having problems. This time it worked really well. Okay, so it seems weird, but the yarn's coming in from the back. But I need my fabric under the needle. So make sure you put your fabric where you want to be stitching, which is under the needle. Okay, so I'll have a little bit of excess yarn at the front. That's okay. And then we're going to have it come down. And there is, believe it or not, a groove in the front of this little plastic attachment. I guess I wasn't really done with my stiletto yet. Yeah, you're not going to be able to see it very well on camera probably, but you can see a little bit of an indent here. That's actually, there's a groove, there's a cut in there to go inside, and that's where you want your yarn to go. You're going to pull that yarn in through the groove and into the little hole there. And then that little hole part is going to keep your yarn there, so it's going to get stitched down. So you just need to pull it in like that. Okay, so you can see it's now in there, and so we're feeding from the back, that little groove in the back, in through the hole. Okay, now... And it seems strange to me because I think, oh, I'm going to be couching this here. No, you're going to be couching the part that's coming behind you. But you're moving forward. There's a lot of things to think about with this foot. Okay, let's get that little bit out of the way there. So I'm just going to put my needle down first. I've got my bobbin thread here. I just want to hang on to my top two threads for the time being. And remember, we're doing free motion here. Now, don't go fast with this either, okay? Take your time. Don't go super slow. But don't go speeding along here or you're going to end up missing some of the yarn. So let's see how we do here. We're just going to go back and forth here a little bit. Maybe not. Doesn't like that I'm not. I have my feed dogs up and down. Okay, so let's see what we're doing here. So you can see... Okay, so you can see it's catching... the yarn as it goes along. It kind of looks like chenille, actually, is what it looks like to me. Okay, I'll just keep going here. So you can make different designs, different shapes. You can go backwards, forwards, whatever you want to do. You can go next to the one you just did and build up a design, maybe a little leaf or something. But you just need to go slowly along. If you're used to machine quilting with machingers or with some gloves on, feel free to do that here as well. That might be a little more helpful for you. And see, we've still got lots of yarn here. We're good. Let's keep going. Okay, make sure my... You want to make sure yarn doesn't get tangled up in the back or get a knot in it either, or that's... You're going to have a problem with that. So you can see what you can do here. So you can add all kinds of dimension to applique shapes, or just if you want to create designs on your fabrics. The other thing you could do is you could couch down one color of yarn and then stop and then go inside with another color yarn. Or what looks really nice with this is if you have yarn that has variegated colors in it, that's beautiful to use with this technique. So if you are looking to do some couching, you want to do some embellishment on your projects, you can look for the Janome Free Motion Couching Set and give it a try.